Okay, student, question number 6. Let star be the binary operation. So this time we don't have to find if this operation is binary or not. They have already given, okay, binary operation on set of natural number given by, now what is this operation? The operation between two element is what? LCM of A and B. If two input you will give, the operation will be what? Will be the operation will be LCM of this two element, okay? LCM of two element will be your output. If your input is A and B, output will be what? LCM of that elements, okay? Now what they have asked you to find? Question number one, they have asked you, okay, let me write down. Set is what? Set of natural number, right? Then what is the operation here? Operation between two element. Two element will be from here only, right? When you will take two element from here and do the operation, what is the operation here? LCM of A and B. So your output will be always LCM of A and B. So try to understand carefully this question. So number one, what they have asked, find 5 star 7 and 20 star 6. So 5 star 7 means LCM of operation is what? LCM between these two elements, right? LCM of 5 and 7. So LCM of 5 and 7 is what? It's 35, right? Next, LCM of 20 and 6. Okay, 6. No, this question is 16, not 6, sorry. 16. So LCM of 20 and 16, it's 80. I hope you know how to find out LCM. We used to find out the prime factorization of 5 and 7, right? And then we used to find out the common element, and whatever common element are there, we used to take it as one element, and then rest uncommon elements, we used to simply multiply, right, with the common one. Right, for example, if someone don't know, prime factorization of 5 is what? If I do prime factorization, 5 times 1, alright, so 5 into 1, 1 if I don't write also no problem. 7 is 7 into 1. So odd number, obviously we know it's simply multiplication. Anyway, there is no common element, so what I said, if there is common, we used to take it as one element, that one, okay? Like for example, 2 is there for prime factorization, here also 2. So that 2 we will take it as 1. Okay, and rest uncommon. Now see, this 5, 7 is uncommon, right? Simply we used to multiply with the common element. But in this case, there is no common element. Here is 1. Let me write down so that you can understand. 1 will be common. We will take it as one element. 1 into uncommon, we used to simply multiply. Now this is just a rule to find out this one. Actual, what is the meaning? Meaning is, we used to find out lowest common, least common multiple, right? Of this one. Now these common multiple, try to understand by the word itself, multiple. So first thing, I have to write down all the multiples here. Which one I will take? I will take that multiple here also. Multiple I will take, I will write down multiple here. Then I will see which one is common, okay? Then out of that common also I will take the lowest one. So see what I mean to say. So first thing, what I'm trying to find, lowest common multiple. So this number which I will write here must be multiple, okay? So multiple. Now what number I will write here such that this number will be multiple of 5? So minimum number will be 5, right? 5 is a number which is multiple of 5. This 5 I can write 5 into 1, that is called multiple, right? Next, 10 will be the next multiple of 5. 10 I can write 5 into 2. Next, 15, 20, 25, 30, these are all multiple of 5. In this way, infinite will be there. Same way for 7, what are the multiples? So minimum number it will be 7. Now I'm taking only positive integer, remember, not negative, okay? Only positive integer. So for 7, minimum multiple will be 7. This 7 I can write 7 into 1. Next, what it will be? 14. 14 I can write 7 into 2. Next, 21, 28, it will go on like this, right? Here also let me write down 35, 40, it will go on, okay? 42, 49, like this it will go on. Now see here, these are what? Multiple of these numbers, right? Now what I want to find out, lowest common multiple of 5 and 7. Why I'm explaining this one? The reason is, when you will deal with identity, associativity, you need to know the meaning. This rule will not help you, meaning will help you, okay? So meaning you have to know carefully. So multiple I have written, now I will find out common multiple. Which one is common? 5 is not common, 10 not common, 14 not, 15 not common, 20 also not, so 35 is common. Can you see? Okay, so next let me write down 56, let it will be bigger. Anyway, after this also common multiple will be there, but I need which one? The lowest common, the so least common multiple is which one? You can see previous, before this one, no multiple are there which are common here. Okay, so the least common multiple here is what? 35. So that's why least common, lowest common multiple of 5 and 7 is 35. I hope you have understood the meaning. This is how we used to find out. Okay, now this is what, this makes us easy to find out this solution. Okay, if we write like this multiple and then find out which one is common and then find out which one is the lowest one, obviously it will take time, right? So this is the method through which you can find out simply. Okay, so what was the method? Common element, we take it as 1. Okay, and then we used to multiply with all uncommon elements, whatever left over, those we used to simply multiply. So result, whatever comes out, that will be your LCM. So try to understand this meaning. This will help you in associative and these things. Okay. So I hope this one is clear, right? Number 2. Is star commutative? Okay. Simply let me. So what do you think? Star commutative means, for commutative, what condition must satisfy? A star B must be equal to B star A. Means if I do the operation like this, first I will take A, then B. Whatever outcome comes out, if I take first B and then A, if it comes out same, the outcome for this and this will be same, then we will call as this operation is commutative. Okay, means order does not matter, it should not matter the order. If I change the position and do the operation, then if it does not change the result, then it will be called as commutative. So let's see here. So what do you think, star operation will be commutative or not? Obviously you see here, if I take two elements, say 5 and 7, 5 star 7 will be what? LCM of 5 and 7, it will be how much? 35, right? Now if I change the order, 7 star 5, if I write like this, now operation is what? LCM, right? So LCM of, this time I will write 7 and 5. Now what do you think, the result will be same or different? Obviously same. LCM of 7 and 5 or LCM of 5 and 7, does not matter, order here does not matter. So this will also give you 35, not only with 5 and 7, with any two element if you take from the set of natural number. Okay, from the set of natural number if you take any two element, and if you take LCM by changing the order, result will always be same. So how to write down? For each A, B belongs to set of natural number, A star B is equal to B star A. Therefore, star is commutative. Okay, this we have written logically. Okay, so you don't have to show, or if you want, you can show some example also like this one. 5 star 7, 7 star 5. It's both same. Okay, example 5 star 7 is equal to 7 star 5. Okay, number 3. Next question number 3, you try to see carefully. Okay, this is all from your analysis. You can write down the answer for this. Okay, so first thing I told you, right? LCM meaning is very important. Now they have asked you, is star associative? Means you have to prove what? For associative, if you take three elements from set of natural number and do the operation like this, first I will do between these two operation. Okay, whatever outcome comes out, if it is equal to A star B star C, if I do operation between these two and then with this one, whatever outcome will be for this and for this, if it is same, then it will be associative means what I want to say, see carefully. I have taken one example. So what I will do basically here, LCM of these two element I will find out. What it will, whatever result comes out, then this result and this result I will find out LCM and then see what result comes out. So here will be the result, right? Then what I will do, I will do operation something like this. First I will do operation between these two, that is LCM of BC I will find out. Whatever result comes out, with that I will find out LCM of these two. Okay, and then the result whatever comes out, I will verify these two are same or not. If it is same, then the operation which is defined, it is associative, right? So see carefully in LCM what happens. I have taken one example, 2, 4, 6. Suppose I have taken this 3 natural number. Now try to see carefully this one. When I have taken 3 element, 2, 4, 6. Now see what I will do. What are the multiples of 2? Minimum number will be 2, right? 2 will be multiple of 2. Then next 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. It will go on like that. Okay. What is the multiple of 4? 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32. It will go on. 6 multiple is 6, 12, 18. This is the actual way to find out LCM. Meaning is this one. Okay. So I am trying to explain you with the help of meaning. 6, 12, 18, 24. These are the multiple. Now see what I will do first. First I will find 2 star 4, 6. First I will find outcome of this one. Okay, what it will be. So see here. First I will take LCM of 2 and 4. So what will be the LCM of 2 and 4? So can you see I have highlighted with this color pen. I am finding LCM of 2 and 4 first. So what will be the LCM of 2 and 4? Can you see lowest common multiple is this one? Right? So between 2 and 4, the lowest common multiple is this one. Right? So what I will do now? 2 and 4, lowest common multiple is 4. So 4 star 6 now I will find out. So for 4 star 6, what I will do? Again, LCM of 4 and 6. So first multiple of 4, then multiple of 6. So multiple of 4 when you write, obviously same, this one will come out, right? Multiple of 4 we already have. So this one will be your multiple of 4. This one will be multiple of 6. So what is the lowest common multiple between 4 and 6? Between 4 and 6, you can see the lowest common multiple is 12. Let me mark with this color. 12 is the lowest common multiple. 4 and 6, lowest common multiple is 12. Okay, so I got the output for this one. Now see, I will find out something like this. First I will find LCM between 4 and 6. What will be the LCM between 4 and 6? Obviously 12, right? Try to understand. Don't think that this and this we are taking in the same way. No, it's not same. So see carefully what I will do. This time 2 star. Now LCM of 2 and 4 is how much? 4 and 6 is how much? 12. Now I have to find LCM of 2 and 12. Now when you find LCM of 2 and 12, you will obviously write down multiple of 2 first. 2, 4, 6, 8, like that it will go on. 8, let me write down. 10, 12, 14. Till 14 let me write down. Next 12 multiple will be what? Minimum number will be 12, right? Here. Because less than this, obviously there will be no multiple of 12. Less than this will not be there. So 12 will be the minimum. Next will be 24 and this way it will go on. So you can see the lowest common multiple between these two is which one? 12 is there. Okay. So here also the result is 12. So can you see? Result is same in both cases, right? So obviously it should be associative. Now with some example you cannot show like this. It must be for all the element. Any three element if you take from the natural number, it must satisfy this condition. Now it will satisfy. Now see why. Instead of finding like this, now see, if I find all together this one, what will be the LCM of 2, 4 and 6 all together if you find out? You can see, if you see here and see here, what is the lowest common multiple in this three element? You can see it will be 12. So what I mean to say from here is, When you find LCM, it does not matter first, you will find this two and when and with this one, or this two first and with this one, or if you find all together, all will be same in LCM. Okay, so basically when you find this one, you are actually finding LCM between three elements at a time, so it will be 12, means LCM of 2, 4, 6. If you find out at a time, whatever result you will get, if you take 2 at a time and then with the third one, then also you will get same, or this 2 at a time and then with the first one, then also you will get same LCM. So LCM, when you will find out order or which one you are taking first, does not matter. It will come out to be same when you take out the LCM for all the element together. I hope you have understood. LCM 2 at a time does not matter. If you find all, whatever comes out, 2 at a time also if you take, and then with the third one, then also it will come out to be same LCM. You can try with other example. If you want, you can take other number here and try this method which I have told you. Always you will get same LCM for 3, whatever comes out, same will come out here also. So in general, how I can write them? So this is analysis. Okay, again I repeat, this is not something which you will have method or something like that. This is from your analysis. You need to study all these things properly, then only things will be clear, all this one. Okay, so anyway, I've given example, I hope you have understood, right? So question number 3, how we will write down? Simple. For all ABC belongs to set of natural number, we have got, right, A star B star C is equal to LCM of A star B. First you will find LCM of this, right? Then with C you will find, then LCM of, now see, LCM of this and this, when you find out whatever result come out, LCM of A, B and C together also give you same. Okay, so here I will write next A star B star C. So first I will find LCM between this. So what it will write? A star LCM of B and C. B and C. Okay, this one N, sorry. NC is equal to LCM of, again see, A star LCM of this two will be what? LCM of ABC, right? ABC. So can you see LCM for this? What is the result? LCM of ABC, for this also LCM of ABC. So does not matter whether you will take 2 at a time or all 3 at a time, does not matter. Okay, so both result will be same, therefore star is commutative. So in your PDF it is written like this. Now most of the student, I know you will not understand this one, so try to see the example which I have given. Okay, from that as analysis only we have written this one. So try to see and try to understand that one. And if you want, you can take more example. Next, number 4. Find identity of star in set of natural numbers. So first thing, identity, what it was. Remember, identity is one element from the set. Means this time, what is the set? Set of natural number, right? From this set, I'll find out one element. Okay? This element, what its kind will be. So see here, if you have identity, definition was, if you have identity, then this element, if you do operation with any other element from this set, say A, then you will always get back this element. So I told you in the definition, identity is those element which does not let the other element lose their identity when you do the operation. Okay, it is that element from this set which, if I do the operation with this, means this time operation is what? LCM. So if I do LCM, if I take LCM with any element, any other element with this, then it will give back that element. For example, example I will give you, suppose 2 is identity. Then with 2, if I take any element, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever it is, if I take it, 3, 4, 5, whatever, then it must give you 3. Now obviously, it's LCM of 3 and 2 is not 3. Okay, so obviously 2 cannot be your identity. I'm just giving you example. If it is identity, then if you do operation, then it must come out same output here, and it does not matter order also here, whether you take identity first and then second this one, then also it must give you back that element. Okay, so which one will be that element, how to find out? So basically, what is the definition here? You have to find that element here, which if I do operation with this, it must give you A. Okay, so if I take A suppose 2, okay, A suppose 3, A suppose 4, whatever I will take from the set of natural number, what element I will take here, the common one, you have to say only one element, which if I take here, LCM will be always here 2, here should be 3, here should be 4. If I take 5 also, outcome should be 5. What element I will take in this way? Now see one observation again. When I have to take LCM between 2 and 4, okay, in case of HCF, remember, in case of HCF, what happened? When I used to find out highest common factor, when it is factor, out of these two number, minimum might be the answer. Means 2 can be the answer. Highest common factor can be the minimum number. Minimum, the answer which you will get, minimum it can be 2. Or it will be more than 2. More than 2 might be there, okay? But minimum it can be 2. But when you find LCM between 2, 4, what answer do you think will you get? It will be always greater than or equal to 4. The maximum, you can see the example which I have given last time also. 2, 4, 6. What will be the LCM of this one? One thing I can say from this, LCM of this 3 will be greater than or equal to 6. I can say that one for sure. Because lowest common multiple when you write, see here, when you write multiple, what you will do? That number whose multiple you are writing, that number will come right first. Because minimum, that will be the multiple. Yes or no? I hope you have understood. The multiple when you will write, the first number will be obviously that same number because it will be the lowest multiple. After that, you will write down the biggest number, right? Now, when you will find out lowest common multiple, now common can be when? That minimum number must be there, right? Suppose 6 is there. Then 6 will be the common element. Now, less than 6 cannot be common because that will not be there in this multiple. I hope you have understood. Less than 6 will not be there. Then how can that be common between these three, right? Then minimum common can be 6. So what I want to say is, when you find out LCM between two number, answer, one observation from this I can have is, answer will be either greater or equal to the biggest number here. So when I will find LCM between 2 and 4, I know that the LCM will be either 4 or greater than 4. So you can see, what will be the LCM here? 4. So it is equal. So what I want to say is, when you will find out LCM between this number and this number, okay, so minimum what it will, what I want to say is, what number you will take here, see, outcome should be what, 2, right? So if I take greater than 2, then this can never be 2, it will be that greater. Suppose I will take 3 here, then it will be more than 3 or equal to 3. So if I need output to one thing, it's clear, either I will take 2 here or less than 2, right? So what I will take here such that it will give LCM 2. So here multiple is 2, minimum 2, then this will come out, right? Now what I will take here such that output will be again 2. So this second number which I will take, obviously I cannot take greater than 2, right? So it might be either less or equal to 2. So if I take 2 here, obviously outcome might be 2. That is LCM might be 2. Okay, if I take 2 here. But this must be identity of this one also. So if I take 2 here, then you will not get output 3 here. If it is 2, the lowest common multiple between these two will be what? 3, then 6 will be here, 2, then here will be 4 like this. So obviously see, 3 will not be common here. So obviously 2 cannot be the identity. So here you cannot take 2. So it will be what? Less than 2, let's try. I hope you are understanding. I cannot take greater than 2. Why? Because if you take greater than 2, first thing it will be clear that 2 you can never get. Because if it is greater, I have already told you. When you find out LCM between two number, the one which is bigger, that will be the answer or greater than that. So if you take bigger than 2, obviously your answer will be either greater than 2 or that number only. Then which number you are taking, either that will be answer or greater than that number. So obviously 2 you can never get, but I have to get 2, then only it will be identity, this element will be identity, right? So to get 2 here, what option I have now? 2 I cannot take, because 2 if I take, this will not be identity in this case. If it is identity, I told you it must be identity for all the elements. For all elements, if you do the operation of that identity with 3, then output must be 3. So if you take 2 here, suppose 2 will give you answer 2 here, right? So you might be thinking that 2 is identity. Now 2 is not identity. You can see 2 if you put here, then LCM of this 3 and 2 will not give you 3. Okay, so 2 cannot be the answer. So I'm not taking 2 here. So other element, is it there through which I can get LCM of this 2? 2. So what will be the element you'll put? Obviously 2, 1, right? Less than 2 I can put. So let's try with 1. So what will be the multiple of 1? 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, all will come. So can you see? Lowest common multiple will be which one? 2 only. So in this case, I can get 2. So 1 might be the answer. So let's check whether other element will give you same output or not. So 1 must be the identity. Let's check. 3 star 1. So 3 and 1, what is the lowest common multiple? 3, 6, 9, 12, like this will go on, right? So in this case, what you will get? 1, 2, 3. Multiple of 1 is what? All number, right? So 3 also I can write 1 into something, 2 also I can write. So in this way, all number you will get. So you can see, what is the lowest common multiple? 3. So 3 star 1, 3. 4 star 1, you can check. 4, 4, 8, 1. If I write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. So what will the lowest common multiple? 4. Can you see? So when I will do operation with 1, always you will get back that element. So 1 is the identity of this operation. I hope it is clear. So try to see this, which I have explained here again and again, if you have not understood. After that also, if you are having doubt, ask me. I will try to explain in a different way, okay? By taking different example. The way will be this one only. This is the best way to understand, okay? So for that, LCM meaning you need to understand carefully. Then only you can understand these things easily. So this hint, try to remember. When we find LCM between any two number, then remember out answer which we will get, it will be either that bigger number out of this, whichever is bigger, either that one or greater than that one. In case of HCF, the lowest one can be the answer. Okay, because HCF, when we find out what we write down here, factors, right? Factors means what? The number which divide this. So 2 divide this one, 2 divides here also. So 2 is the highest, like the 2 can be the highest common factor. So 2 can be the answer in case of HCF, lowest one. But in LCM, the answer will be either the bigger one or greater than that number. Okay, so this observation is very important here. So how you'll write number 4? So we have seen, right, for all element, if I do operation with 1, then used to get back that element, right? So to write down 1, 2, 3, instead of writing all that, shall I write like this? For all, A belongs to natural number, whatever A you take. A star 1 is equal to 1 star A. If you take 1 and LCM, order does not matter, right? So that's why I'm writing A star 1, 1 star A also you can write. That was the definition, right? A star 1 is equal to A, it give back this one. Or if you take 1 star A also, it will give back this one. So therefore, 1 is the identity of operation star. Okay, now the last question for this: which elements of set of natural number are invertible for the operation star? So they are asking invertible. Now which element will be invertible? Now remember invertible, what I say, the definition was when an element will be called as invertible. For example, A, one element I have taken from here. When this element will be called as invertible? When you do operation of this element with some element, any element, if you do the operation, if you get identity, what is the identity here? 1, right? Right? Identity for this operation is 1. So when this element will be invertible. If you have an element with which if you do the operation, you get back identity. Then that element will be, this element will be called as invertible. You have to get an element with which if you do the operation, then you get identity. So what element I will take such that you will get 1? So see carefully. Here also observation is very important. 1, 2, 3. A, you take anything. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, anything. If you do operation with some element, okay, any element here, you have to get LCM 1, identity you have to get. Right? You have to get identity. What element you will take? Obviously, it might make you confused, student. So you need to practice little bit this one, okay? But don't be afraid. Try to practice again and again. This, after you will get little bit mature with this, then things will be easier again, okay? Since you are doing for the first time, you might be thinking that it's tough. So try to practice little bit, it will come out, okay? So what was invertible? Remember invertible definition. When an element will be called an invertible, A is called invertible if there exists B belongs to set. So this time set of natural number, I will write natural number only. A is called invertible when there exists B such that A star B, when you do operation with B, you will get identity element. Okay, so in this operation identity is 1, so A will be called as invertible when, if you can operate this A with one element which will give you output identity element. So I'm writing like this. What is the A here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, anything, natural number, right? So if you do operation with any element here, it must give you identity. What is that element? I have to find out. So see here, what I will take here such the output will be 1. So see, I told you, right? Whichever is the bigger number here, output will be either that bigger number or greater than. Now see, output is already 1. So can you take greater than 1? Obviously, no. Right? And minimum than 1, okay, for 1 you might be thinking, okay, 1, okay, LCM of 1, 1 is 1, okay, let me take here. Now see, if it is 2 here, if I put 2 here, then what will happen? LCM will be 2, minimum answer output will be what? The one which is greater, right? So if I put 1 here, then also output will be what? Here also it will be, output will be minimum 2. Output you can get minimum 2, because I told LCM between two element will be what? Output can be the one which is bigger. So if I take 1 here, then answer will be what? Either 2 or greater than 2. Obviously you will never get 1, right? Here also, and bigger than that to number also you cannot put, right? Because output you have to get 1. So the only option was 1, which is also not satisfying. So 2 is not invertible at all. 3